prefer that we set the matter for hearing.
I am aware, yes.
And so, if you are saying affidavit evidence and she's saying oral position,
yes,
that even if they are given how much time, they will not be able to prove their case.
It's okay. I leave it to the court.
Yeah, but when one is claiming that I was given a gift by the deceased, submissions wouldn't do.
Okay.
He must be allowed to tender oral evidence and call witnesses if they are.
That's okay, yeah.
Okay.
It's just that the issue of time here was...
My colleague, Mr. Ching, is holding before Tiende Amolo, for the objectors. And my learned colleague, Mr. Swaka, is also present. He filed an application for an interested party to be enjoined, one B.B. Ogwen. My lord, after we were last before you, the parties have met a couple of times for purposes of having this matter possibly settled. We have not reached that position yet, but we are still ongoing with those talks. We would have been asking for your indulgence perhaps to mention this matter after about 2 weeks for purposes of hopefully recording a settlement in this matter. The unfortunate event, we then will proceed. But for that purpose, my colleague may very well file a different application if we do not succeed in the settlement, so we very well grant him leave to file any subsequent summons in the event that we do not succeed. That's Mr. Cheng, who is holding you for Utiende Amolo. But we'll ask for your indulgence for about 2 weeks. We should be able to settle this matter.
I believe that none of the parties is opposed to
join.
Yeah, to the mother of the twins being enjoined in the matter.
Mm-hmm.
So as perhaps to bring about more clarity and so that everybody may be factored in. So we pray that it goes on record that the same is not opposed.
Mm-hmm.
I think my colleagues are in agreement with that. So that even as we retire, perhaps to try and fine-tune the remaining issues, we may be able to do that confidently, knowing that there's a positive outcome at the end of the day.
So, Chief,
there's a lot of count in the short period that you have had to produce the documents.
The only difference is that in the negotiations we have been with a different counsel. My colleague, Mr. Ching, has only just come in. So I think that's where the little mishaps are. But on the issue of joining up for the administrators, we are not opposed to.
As having been a friend to the late Fidel Odinga, with whom it's believed they sired two children, who are the minor twins, who have been mentioned equally in the papers.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's paramount, it's very, very important, that then she gets enjoined in the matter to bring about clarity and to be able to secure the interests of these minor children.
So she's the mother of children?
That's right.
Is it admitted by... In fact, when the papers were filed by
Mr. Cheng's client.
The Cheng's client?
Yes, but the
you're the ones. You're the ones who said that his client is the mother of the two children.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you wouldn't then be opposed to their joinder, because you can't discuss children and exclude the mother from this discussion.
My lord, whereas we are live to the court's sentiments, we just note that we were instructed yesterday. So in all fairness, we would be seeking time.
You want to say something about that?
Instructions on the question. Yes, ma'am.
Just to help the court. Just as the court has actually pointed out, and unless they want to depart from that position. Their position was very clear, that we have two children out there who belong to the late Fidel. They even mentioned the mother, they mentioned the two children, they have attached their birth certificate.
Mm.
I really don't think there is an issue to really oppose.
So that so that we can move forward in this matter, I think we need to settle whether or not, you know, what is the status of Mr. Swaka in this matter.
That's right.
So that is something that we need to clear now.
Yes, it ought to be clear.
So either that must be dealt with now, unless, because the law would be in their favor to just join. Whatever decision would be made ultimately is beside the point. Mr. Chair.
My Lord.
Hmm?
Yes, we want time to file a revocation application.
Not revocation. Yes. We are not talking about revocation. We are talking about joint. Because even in the revocation, when you they will have to be heard in it. What is their status here in this matter before we even allow you to file for revocation?
Yes, my Lord. In that case, then I would indicate to court that they can be enjoined at this stage, and then they would now substantiate their position as regards the state and subsequent proceedings. But as the joinder,
tell me, are you laying claim to the estate?
No, no, not as the mother. She's
I consent, you remember, Mr. Sagana?
Yes.
That these children be subjected to DND.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, the mother comes up, I've read the papers, the mother comes up and say, hey guys, you are discussing my children.
I need to speak for myself.
I need to speak for them. That's really all that they are doing for the time being. As to whether they will lay claim to the estate, that's really up to them.
Most of them.
Isn't it? So
yes.
We agree that...
Yes, ma'am.
Let's see how it goes after that, isn't it?
That's the position.
My consent application dated when?
It's dated the 18th of October. Seeking to enjoin Phoebe Akin Ogweli.
So allowed, yes. The objectors have lived. Of 7 days to file themselves an application for revocation, you say?
Yes, ma'am.
To which you'll have how many days to respond?
I could take equal amount of time.
Equal amount, which the instructors and the interested party.
We'll equally ask for leave, just in case we need to respond to any information that comes.
Yes, yes.
That's an interesting part.
So you have 7 days within which to file and serve your application for revocation, to which you'll have 7 days to respond. And then parties allowed to negotiate.
Yes, my lord. I think that's pretty much up to us, but we can mention this in 2 weeks' time so that we can take different directions. We may either be taking a date for subsequent hearings of the summons or recording a settlement.
So you mentioned on 27?
We'll do it on 28th, my lord, in case you're sitting on 28th. It's a Thursday.
Yeah, Thursday is my adoption and matrimonial property.
Okay, we can do it to 27th in the morning.
So, Cheng, that's fine?
It is okay, ma'am.
Thank you.
We are most obliged.
Thank you.
Most obliged.
P&N number 494.
You can carry your